While hosting a webinar on ClickMeeting, you have multiple options to manage the attendees and presenters. These options will give you full control over your event. Right now, we are in the webinar room. Let's begin by clicking on a chosen name in an attendee list. Let's say John. Here's his name, email address, a list of handy options, and his location. Choose the one option to make John a presenter. He will be asked to give his browser access to his mic and camera. After accepting it, he can go live immediately and have full control over what is displayed in the webinar room. If chosen by mistake, you can make John an attendee again. If you wish to let John speak briefly, instead of giving him all presenter rights, just turn this switch on. He will receive a message informing him that he is allowed to broadcast audio. To do this, he needs to turn on his microphone by clicking the appropriate icon. At any time, you can click his name or click this icon to toggle the menu again. Turning the switch off will immediately turn his microphone off and prevent him from turning it on again. You can do exactly the same thing for video. Just turn the switch on to allow John to turn his camera on. Turn it off to disable it. If you wish John to present his screen to the audience, turn this switch on. He will be notified that he can share the screen by choosing the relevant icon. Turn the switch off to revoke this permission. By selecting the Block User option, you will take away the user's rights to stream audio, video, screen share, and use chat. John will not be able to perform any of these actions until you unblock him. Relogging an attendee may come in handy if John experiences any browser issues. This action will also remove all previously granted permissions. Selecting Log Out will remove John from the webinar room. There is another quick option to disable the user's audio or video device or stop him from sharing his screen. While John has his camera, microphone, or screen sharing enabled, you can turn them off by simply clicking relevant icons on the attendee list next to his name. Note that this action will not take away his permission to re-enable them. For instance, you can use this option if John has forgotten to turn his mic off. You can do the same thing even quicker by clicking on John's microphone icon here. It's worth noting that those options are handy not only during a webinar, but also during a meeting. The last feature we'll show you is helpful when someone important is missing. Choose this icon in the attendee list and type in his email address or telephone number. Confirm by clicking Send to make sure he receives a link to your event. Use these options during your next webinar or meeting to stay in full control of your event.